This will make a racket. Beauteous.
All of them?
Yeah, I don't know how anything could have stayed in there. We need more.
We do.
Oh.
Come back a little bit more. I put you back on stock. Okay.
I turned the truck off.
Oh. Okay, let it rip. Let's see where this gets us.
Okay.
Starts sinking in the mud. Thank you. thing, that's going to be a great base.
Yeah, it's already filled in with rocks.
Yeah. What do you think? Does that look pretty perpendicular with a... that straight across? I can't get over there.
No?
No. I don't think.
It's pretty damn close.
Okay.
I think for the most part...
we'll make it up at this end to make it straight.
Okay.
Okay, let's do some fabric and we'll start shoving rocks in there. That on the other side of that big one.
That's what I was thinking. Like that?
Yeah. A medium well.
Yeah, there a little bit.
That's the bucket pin. If you look on the other side, there's a retaining ring. And it just slides through an opening in the bucket.
Gotcha.
And they just weld a big old washer on the end of it.
Interesting.
Yeah. High tech.
Yeah, I thought it was broken.
Thank you. Yeah, now we're into dust. Before we were in mud. It warmed up. Or is it just me?
Oh yeah, it warmed up. Now we're in the sun.
Oh well, this is true, yeah. Because it hasn't been able to run out. I think I'm gonna go up and dig that a little deeper. Thank you.
see. So this is the inlet from upstream. A lot of dirt and silt gets washed down through this section here, and as you can see, it's real powdery, real fine. It just filled in where they had laid these kind of small, medium-sized stone. Just backfilled it super full to where that was about 3/4 all the way full in the pipe. And it was causing this area to flood real bad this last rainy season. So we dug this all out. All in here is some lovely fresh mint and spearmint. Smelled amazing when we were taking it out to clear out this drainage channel here. So we had to kind of excavate this area too. Same thing, kind of filled in with silt and sediment and dirt. So we dug that all out, laid some fabric down, and then kind of backfilled it with all these pretty moderate sized stone here that came from the property. As we follow this down, came to another pipe where it had filled up 2/3 to the inlet. So I had to shovel that out. Same thing, filled up majority of that pipe on this side. All of these were kind of damming up at the inlets and outlets. So he came in with his bucket, with the single tiger teeth, I believe, and kind of just raked the surface off. It was that kind of material there with all the really like interweaved rooting, and it did amazing. He did quick work of that. So follow this along, we got the entrance to the bridge, another build up of sediment and silt. Here, that was about half full into the pipe with this gravel and sediment and silt and all that stuff. So came in here, dug it out, made it a bit wider, kind of just worked our way down. A ton of gravel in here. Keep on going. Made it a bit wider, but kept a margin along the bank there so that it wouldn't erode the bottom side of that stone wall. Keep that intact. And we created these silt and sediment barrier walls with some rock. So the idea is to catch most of the larger stuff, or just catch as much as we can with the first one, and it'll kind of settle into there, and as water keeps flowing over, it'll bring the lighter stuff down, and it widens out to where the secondary area for it to settle is a bit larger, and created a nice, probably a couple foot deep by 3 foot in width, and laid some fabric down in there, got some large stones in there, kind of built it up for another barrier so that the sediment and silt that backfilled all the way up from upstream doesn't make its way into the pond. So, and we all this area right here. You see that edge that we carved out, kept another margin of safety against that stone wall, but we carved out all the, I think it was duckweed that was filling in there, and gave it a bit more real estate when this decides to fill. So yeah, it was a good project. A lot of fun. Beautiful property, beautiful weather. It was about 75 degrees both days while we were here. Pretty brisk in the mornings, but sunny and windy in the evenings, and man, it was fun. Over down the way there, over on that end, they've got probably, I don't know, 30, 40 yards of large stones like these ones here. And so we transported in the dump bed loads of rock down here, and I just backed the truck up right in here and dumped them down in there, and he was down the excavator just kind of placing them. Yeah, it was good work. He managed to get that little U17 all the way out there. This stuff right here was extremely wet and moist, and every time he'd drive over, it would be pushing water up on everywhere around him. And so he was kind of slowly making it worse as he was doing that. So he just kind of carved that out, and that ground was a lot firmer over there. He just made his way back. We didn't have a way to get all of that stuff out of here efficiently loading it onto something, so he just kind of kept compounding his pile, slowly making a big pile, readjusting, compounding the new dig with the old pile, and kept working it all the way over here till we got it out here. And then we used the Yard Max tracked wheelbarrow to truck it over here. I mean, this is probably 20 or 30 loads here. And yeah, some good fertile compost soil, nice and moist. They're gonna let it dry out and use it after that. So fun project, and it went well for the most part. No complaints. So we took the first probably four excavation loads from the outlet of the bridge right there. Hauled them all the way up the hill here. And a nice compost pile with some hardwood chips, because they had quite a few trees come down this last year. And we're just throwing all the extra grass and soil onto there, and this will be a massive compost pile, but it'll do good.